Hello, 2020 graduates. Congratulations on making it to the finish line. Everything you've achieved up to this point has led to this moment, but this is only the beginning. There are amazing things waiting for you in the future, and we know that whatever you do, you will continue to make us proud. So reach high, everyone, and remember that truly the best are with CPS. Congratulations.
Hello, scholars, families, and friends. Welcome to our virtual graduation. We are so proud of you and all that you have accomplished during your time at Prieto. I never imagined that my first year as principal would end with a virtual graduation. I am so proud of the resiliency, strength, and perseverance you have shown as we have had to change our whole way of life as the world deals with the coronavirus pandemic. From remote learning to caring for your families and communities, you have shown that you are truly stars. I am honored to welcome you to our virtual graduation ceremony. Let's begin with the 8th grade awards.
Muy buenas tardes, habla el señor Cuellar, soy el nuevo asistente director aquí en la Escuela Prieto. Yo les quiero dar la más cordial bienvenida a cada uno de ustedes, nuestros estudiantes, sus familias, amigos y amistades que están acá, que juntos nos unimos a celebrar esta graduación, aunque virtual. Nosotros nos sentimos tan orgullosos de todo el trabajo duro que han demostrado nuestros estudiantes durante esta pandemia. La verdad que nos sentimos muy contentos de ver la perseverancia y el trabajo duro que han demostrado y enfrente a la adversidad. La verdad, muchas gracias por estar. Espero que disfruten esta ceremonia.
Muy buenas tardes. Mi nombre es Roxana González y yo soy maestra de Ciencias Sociales en la Escuela de Prieto. Good afternoon. My name is Roxana González and I am the 8th grade social studies teacher at Prieto. Today it's my honor to celebrate the graduation with all of you and to honor two of our graduating students with the Excellence in Social Studies Award. Hoy es mi placer y honor poder celebrar su graduación y dar el premio a dos de nuestros estudiantes por excelencia en ciencias sociales. These two students have been leaders in critical thinking and questioning the world around us. Esos dos de nuestros estudiantes han sido líderes en nuestra comunidad de pensar críticamente de nuestro mundo y de lo que hemos aprendido en clase. Throughout this really difficult year, these two students have led with leadership and grace as they have set an example for the rest of us to continue learning to think critically and to question the world around us. Estos dos de nuestros estudiantes han sido líderes durante este año escolar muy difícil y nos han ayudado a todos a aprender qué significa pensar críticamente de nuestro mundo. The two students that I am honoring with the Social Studies and Excellence Award are Leilani Quesada and Thomas Alvarez. Thank you for your leadership. I look forward to seeing the opportunities and leadership roles that you will take on in the future. Continue making us proud and leading by example. Thank you. Los dos estudiantes que he escogido para este premio son Leilani Quesada y Thomas Alvarez. Gracias por su liderazgo, por ayudar a todos a seguir aprendiendo. Y me da mucho gusto y estoy muy contenta de seguir escuchando los logros que tienen en su futuro. Gracias.
Saludos. Mi nombre es Daniel Gray. Yo tengo el honor de presentar el Premio de Artes del Lenguaje hoy. Este año, el Premio Language Arts simboliza la excelencia académica y empática porque dos estudiantes han hecho con sus habilidades lingüísticas. Aunque nuestra escuela, especialmente el octavo grado, está llena de estudiantes que se preocupan por los demás en sus clases usando habilidad lingüísticas. Este premio es para los estudiantes que han usado constantemente sus habilidades lingüísticas en español para mejorar la vida de los demás en aula de inglés. He sido muy afortunado de tenerlos ambos como co-maestros para nuestros estudiantes de español dominante. Gracias por su ayuda y liderazgo. El premio de este año va para Melissa Salgado y Esteban Padilla. Yeah, good afternoon. My name is Daniel Gray, and I have the honor of presenting the Language Arts Award today. And this year, like I said, the Language Arts Award symbolizes two things. It symbolizes academic and empathetic excellence for what two students have done with their language skills. And although our school, especially the eighth grade, has lots and lots of students who care about others, who are learning English, this award goes to two students who have constantly used their Spanish language skills to enhance the lives of others in an English language arts classroom. So I've been really fortunate to have both of you guys as really not just co-teachers, but a teacher for me in the Spanish language and for our Spanish dominant learners. So thank you guys so much for your leadership and your help. And so this award goes to two students, Melissa Salgado and Esteban Padilla. Great job, guys. So proud of you. Thanks so much.
Good afternoon. My name is Les Seitman, and I'm the 8th grade physical science teacher at Dr. Jorge Prieto Math and Science Academy. Today, I have the distinct honor and privilege of awarding two scholars from the graduating class with the 2020 Science Award. These two scholars, on a day-to-day basis, participated in class, showed a love for science, always were team leaders at their table, and continued to show growth, progress, critical thinking, analytical skills, even while we were away from the classroom during remote learning. The two scholars that will receive the Science Award 2020, Dr. Jorge Prieto Math and Science Academy, are Stephanie Mejica and Otoniel Salgado Adame. Congratulations, you two.
Hey, everybody. While I would love to give a math award to everyone who took math class in eighth grade this year because you all contributed to the class in different ways, I am going to take this opportunity to honor three scholars who really embodied some of the most important qualities of being a mathematician: a generosity to share their understanding with others, a huge amount of effort and thoughtfulness put into their written work, and most importantly, a vulnerability and willingness to show when they didn't understand something, when they had a question. And that's one of the most important things to look for in a mathematician, because otherwise we can't really learn. So congratulations for all of those things to Angel Areola, Jasmine De Jesus, and Alexi Gonzalez. Great job, guys.
Greetings, families, friends, and a 2020th graduating class of Dr. Jorge Prieto Math and Science Academy. I am here today to present this year's award for outstanding character. This year, we have four awardees. The recipients of this award each share some things in common. They know we should treat people with dignity and humanity, even when we may not always understand or agree with them. They know the talents and abilities we as people do possess far outweigh those we may lack. They know that what we can do for ourselves and for others warrants more recognition than what we cannot do or where we may fall short. They know that a person's feelings matter more than the latest challenge, tweet, or social media post. To them, we all matter all the time. the recipients of this year's Outstanding Character Award, know that color is more important when creating a masterpiece of art. And you, me, and everyone across communities matter all the time, regardless of the shades of our skin or kinkiness of our hair. And they dream with the late Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., and that people should not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. They know we are all worthy and relevant all the time. And with this, my Prieto family and friends, I say let's go forth and show our greatness all the time, just like this year's recipients of the Award for Outstanding Character. From room 323, Dana Butler. From room 214, Geronimo Garcia. Also from room 214, Yamilet Gonzalez. And from room 325, Luz Maria Palmerio. Congratulations, awardees.
Hey, it's Ms. Dill. I'm the art teacher, in case you forgot. It's been a long time. I'm sitting here in my gallery of art for our online learning, and I am here to present the award for Prieto Arts. On the cool side of that, there are two recipients this year, Sitlali and Jasmine. Sitlali has been a part of the Mural Club for many years, helping make our school more beautiful. She's made scenery for the plays and always does amazing work in the art classroom. Jasmine is an artist in and out of the classroom. She spends her time making art that brings joy to her teachers and her friends. Congratulations, you two, and congratulations, 8th grade class. Bye!
Hey there! Well done, 2020 Pulsar graduates. We are so proud of you. And I feel so fortunate to have had all of you in my classroom throughout your tenures at Prieto. I would like to give a little bit more specific congratulations to Jonathan Sanchez and Evelyn Garcia on winning the 2019-2020 Phys Ed Award. These two individuals embody what it means to be a Prieto Pulsar. Hard work, compassion, and determination are what they bring to PE class every day. They model sportsmanship and are always aiming to improve on their skills. Good luck next year in high school. We'll miss both of you here at Prieto.
The Upstander Award goes to Liliana Marchand. The Prieto Award goes to Jayla Perez. Our 8th grade salutatorian is Oscar Garcia. Our 8th grade valedictorian is Luis Villegas. Now we will hear the valedictory address from our valedictorian, Luis Villegas.
Good afternoon, teachers, parents, family members, scholars, and everyone else in the online world listening into our graduation celebration. Finally, we can say we made it through so many challenges. Buenas tardes, maestros, padres, familiares, estudiantes y todos los demás en el mundo en línea, escuchando nuestra celebración de graduación. Finalmente, podemos decir lo logramos a través de tantos desafíos. First, I would like to say thank you. This award is meaningful to me because the recognition reflects on the way I approach each day. Hard work will eventually pay off, and this is what I did every day and all year. Also, it's meaningful to me because it shows with constant effort, you can achieve any goal, no matter how high it is, and reach it. The secret is persistence. Mostly, I have tried to be the best scholar I can be. I thrive and express the real me by giving my full effort on things so people know I'm hardworking. I'm able to express myself when I can accomplish multiple things. Quiero dar gracias por ganarme este premio. Eso significa mucho para mí porque refleja mi trabajo duro que hice todo el año. Secondly, even though the year was not the beautiful sky after a rainy day, some clouds are beginning to fade away. In the same way, I am trying to see beyond the challenges like teachers on strike for 2 whole weeks, which we missed of school. Also, we had to contend with the coronavirus crisis, clipping our year and harming families and challenging our ideas of what graduation should be. Tuvimos un año difícil. Tuvimos el coronavirus hacer difícil nuestro año. We had to struggle in online learning, which also ruined all of our fun plans for the end of the year. In all this, I noticed some beautiful things. I spoke Spanish more. I remembered the good times, like when Michael brought 3 boxes of ice cream sandwiches and 2 melted, or when we piled 30 people in a CTA bus after walking the whole time at the 606 on our class field trip. Better yet, we saw families help each other and manage the tension of our community being the hardest hit with the COVID-19. En resumen, vimos a familias ayudarse en tiempos difíciles con el COVID-19. In these tough times, my parents were very supportive. They helped me feel ready to go. Each day, my mom and dad are always encouraging me to do good in school, to have options in life through hard work and effort. En estos tiempos difíciles, mi familia y mis papás me ayudaron mucho porque me apoyaron mucho. Also, all teachers in the 8th grade are very encouraging and supportive by helping and teaching me new things every day. Papás son buenos apoyos para cuando te sientes mal y te ayudan a completar las cosas que quieres hacer. Last but most important, as an encouragement, I challenge everybody in the class of 2020 to push themselves in what they are passionate about and magnify their talents in whatever high school they are going to attend. Para confianza, yo quiero que todos traten su mejor esfuerzo para que hagan lo que quieren. Seriously though, where you go is second. First is how much you will push yourself in your classes. Finally, I wish everybody the best of luck for the future. Yo deseo la mejor suerte para todos. Pursue your life with passion. Échale ganas.
I'm happy to introduce our graduation speaker. Miss Marielle Laureano was the founding principal at Prieto starting in 2009 and served our community as principal until 2019. She watched you grow up in the halls of Prieto, and I am so happy that she is able to join us today. Thanks, Marielle.
Hello, Prieto families, staff, and my dear, dear scholars. It is an absolute honor to address this year's graduating class of Dr. Jorge Prieto Math and Science Academy. It seems like just yesterday, many of you walked through the doors of Prieto as young kindergartners. You walked through the doors of a learning community that we would build together. As you grew as scholars and as learners, you contributed to making Prieto the very special place that it is today. You brought Prieto to life. Prieto shines because of your light. As you continue to grow and as you move on to the next journey in life, I know that you will continue to shine on, that you will bring light to our communities, that you, like Dr. Jorge Prieto himself, be a constant light of hope in our communities, even during difficult times. This year has undoubtedly brought us challenges to test our character, but you are here, graduating. You did it. You persevered. You are a star. You did not give up. As you leave Prieto, I know that you will continue to shine, to show strong character, to stand behind what is right and what is just. Go out and change the world. Shine on, scholars. Es un honor celebrar este día tan especial con ustedes. La Escuela Prieto desarrolló como una comunidad especial gracias a las contribuciones, talentos y carácter de cada uno de ustedes. Tengo toda la confianza que continuarán desarrollando su carácter para darle voz a nuestras comunidades. Ustedes son estrellas y sé que tendrán muchos éxitos.
Itzel Aguilar, Daisy Aguilar Flores, Denise Alvarado, Thomas Alvarez, Desiree Alvarado, Joshua Angulo, Alexander Arana, Miguel Ariano, Angel Ariola, Jafet Avar, Jonathan Baena, Eroni Barrera, Diana Blancas, Dana Butler, Axel Calderon, Alonso Campis, Mario Carino, Melanie Carrera, Michael Castillo, Evelyn Catalan, Brianna Chico, Luis Cortez, Rodrigo Cuevas, Jasmine De Jesus, Daisy Delgado, Brandon Diaz, Kevin Diaz, Manuel Diaz, Saul Diaz, Jose Echevarria, Juliana Espino Perez, Isaiah Ezel, Severi Farias Talavera, David Flores, Luis Flores, Anthony Fontanez, Juan Frias, Elani Galindo, Giovanni Gama, Daniela Garcia, Evelyn Garcia, Guadalupe Garcia, Geronimo Garcia, Oscar Garcia, Valeria Garcia, Adrian Giron, Lester Godinez, Adamarie Gonzalez, Alexi Gonzalez, Amariani Gonzalez, Isaiah Gonzalez, Yamilet Gonzalez, Joshua Guerra, Randy Gutierrez, Edison Guzman, Dulce Hernandez, Jimmy Hernandez, Karen Hernandez, Omar Hernandez, Montserrat Lino, Michelle Lopez, Jaslyn Maldonado, Jared Maldonado Figueroa, Genesis Maradiaga, Adolfo Marchan, Liliana Marchan, Jasmine Martinez, Jasmine Martinez Arteaga, Javier Martinez Garcia, Stephanie Mejia, Edwin Menez Garcia, Daniel Montiel Mondragon, Alexandra Mora, Areli Moreno, Jason Najera, Lisandro Navas, Alfredo Nevarez, Kayla Nieves, Brandy Noriega, Delilah Noriega, Josue Ocampo, Ronaldo Ocampo, Uriel Ocampo, Grecia Ocon, Leila Orcasitas, Esteban Padilla, Oscar Padilla, Luz Maria Palmeno, Jocelyn Partida, Donisha Pastrana, Allison Perez, Carmen Perez, Jayla Perez, Guadalupe Perez Zavala, Randall Pichardo, Armani Patachny, Leilani Quesada, Laura Rangel, Alessandra Rosso, Daniela Reynoso, Jose Rivas, Brianna Rivera, Ariel Rivera Salas, Joel Rocha, Daisy Rodriguez, Isaiah Rodriguez, Jose Roman, George Salgado, Melissa Salgado, Otoniel Salgado Adame, Eduardo Sanchez, Jonathan Sanchez, Cassandra Sanchez, Roberto Sanchez, Iker Santana, Perla Sapon, Ivan Suarez Sandoval, Tanya Toribio, Jason Trejo, Hector Trinidad, Abril Urgiles Castro, Vanessa Vallejo, Sidlali Venancio, Graciela Verduzco Avalos, Luis Viegas, Noel Zayas, Angel Zapeta.
Graduating class of 2020. When we first started this school year, none of us could have imagined the challenges that we would face. The strike last fall, as the teachers fought for the things that we know that our schools deserve. The coronavirus shutdown that has shaken our entire community and has impacted a lot of our lives. And the remote learning that we have been engaged with in the last few months. As I think about this very challenging school year, I think about what our world needs. And what I've come to is that our world needs us to step up and to think about, to reimagine what our world could be. As we reimagine the world and we work towards building that world that we want, what kind of world do you want to see? I know I want to live in a world without fear. I want to live in a world where we don't fear ICE coming into our communities and separating our families. I want to live in a world without fear of police and violence with our Black brothers and sisters. I want to live in a world without fear of paying our rent or thinking about where our next meal will come. That's the kind of world that I want to live in. And I promise you that I will continue fighting for that world. I invite you to join me in fighting for that world and building that world as you head off into high school and you have opportunities to raise your voice and tell your stories. I encourage you to take those opportunities because our world needs you. I want to thank you, class of 2020, for challenging me this year. It hasn't always been easy, and we've had, you know, a lot of ups and downs. But I thank you for challenging me to be a better teacher and to being a better person. I know I'm the person I am today because I have been your teacher. As I leave Prieto this year and leave Chicago this year, I'm proud to have been your teacher and to have been able to share those learning experiences with you and to have known you. I look forward to hearing about your future success, the leadership opportunities that you will take, and the ways that you will change the world into a better place. A los padres, to the parents, I want to thank you for allowing me to be part of your child's learning experience. A los padres, les quiero agradecer que me hayan dejado ser parte de la vida de sus hijos. Para mí es también un año muy especial. Este es mi último año en Prieto y me voy a mover a Nueva York, so no voy a estar en Chicago el próximo año. Ha sido un placer poder trabajar con ustedes, con muchos de sus hijos, otros hijos también, y les agradezco que hayan abierto sus corazones para ser parte de esta comunidad juntos. As I shared in Spanish, this is also a very special year for me at Prieto. It's my last year at Prieto, and I will be moving to New York. I just want to thank you for allowing me to be part of your community. I've had the chance, you know, to be your child's teacher this year, but for a lot of you, I've had the chance to teach your older children as well. So thank you for allowing me to be part of this community and for sharing your children with me. Quiero también compartir el mensaje en español para todos. Cuando empezamos este año escolar, nadie pudo haber previsto lo que iba a pasar este año con la huelga, con la virus y con tener que estar en casa durante esos últimos meses. Cuando pienso de lo que ha pasado este año, pienso mucho en qué es lo que necesitamos en nuestro mundo ahora. Y pienso que lo que necesitamos en nuestro mundo es necesitamos imaginar un mundo diferente y trabajar para crear ese mundo juntos. Cuando yo pienso en el mundo que yo quiero vivir, pienso en un mundo sin miedo. Pienso en un mundo sin miedo, que venga ICE a nuestras comunidades y nos separe a nuestras familias. Pienso en un mundo sin miedo a la policía y la violencia que ellos toman en nuestras comunidades, especialmente en las comunidades negras. Pienso en un mundo sin miedo a cómo vamos a pagar la renta y cómo y dónde va a venir nuestra próxima comida y cena. Los invito a también imaginar un mundo sin miedo. Un mundo donde todos podemos compartir y ser libres. Les quiero agradecer por dejarme ser parte de sus vidas. Ha sido un año difícil para todos, también para mí. Pero yo soy una mejor persona y mejor maestra por haber sido su maestra. I'm going to end by reciting in Lakesh, because I think this poem and these words, as simple as they are very powerful. So voy a terminar con un poema que se llama In Lakesh. Son palabras simples, pero son palabras muy poderosas. En casa, si lo saben, pueden leerlo conmigo. In Lakesh, tú eres mi otro yo. You are my other me. Si te hago daño a ti, if I do harm to you, me hago daño a mí mismo. I do harm to myself. Si te amo y respeto, if I love and respect you, me amo y respeto yo. I love and respect myself. Congratulations, class of 2020. I'm very proud of you. Muy orgullosa de ustedes. Felicidades.
So, scholars, this is the opportunity that I have to share with you some parting remarks. And first of all, I want to say how proud I am to have taught and coached and talked with so many of you over these last days where we were separated because of the coronavirus. And I know that many of you have had to be resilient within your families to take care of one another, to pick up the slack, and still you've kept up with all the work and all the activity and all the responsibility that we as teachers have asked you to manage. I just can't say how challenging I've seen that to be for you and how unfair at the same time. But even in the unfairness, listen guys, it's going to cause you to grow. Please, please, please don't misinterpret that. Yes, it was unfair to not have graduation opportunities like anybody else. Yes, it was unfair to finish out your year in this manner. But wow, what an opportunity to grow, to care about your families, to care about one another, and to think differently. So I guess my parting words are always remember that those things that tend to get us down, those things that tend to be the most unfair in life, also are those opportunities to be resilient and grow and meet the needs of others. I so appreciated being your teacher. I feel like we have unfinished business. So please stop by the school when this corona social distancing thing is over. It will be great just to catch up, to hear stories. Who knows where our paths may cross in the future. I so appreciated the time that we got to have to mix it up, to read books, to talk about real stuff. And I will miss you guys. So congratulations, class of 2020.
Good afternoon. First and foremost, I want to welcome anybody that is currently viewing this. That might be parents, extended family, staff, teachers, anybody at this point in time that's viewing this video, welcome to the 2020 Dr. Jorge Prieto Math and Science Academy virtual graduation. Class of 2020, it has been a definite honor and privilege on my end getting to know you this year. We spent approximately 28 weeks in the classroom together, which is a short period of time, undoubtedly. However, in those 28 weeks, I got to know a lot of you very closely. I got to know you as a group very well, and there are some definite dynamic personalities in that group, and undoubtedly you will become the future leaders of this country. I don't have any reservations whatsoever in saying that. My greatest pride and joy with this group was after the declaration of stay at home, through remote learning, many of you, the vast majority of you, on a day-to-day basis, tuned into science class to stay up to date with topics, with conversations. You completed those Khan Academies virtually. You completed those News ELAs virtually. You came to class with ideas about what was going on in our world and why we were staying at home. And that, to me, is truly impressive. That speaks to your character as a group. You wanted to know more. You had hypotheses on what was going on and what was occurring. And from a science teacher's point of view, I couldn't be prouder of this group. In closing, I wanted to say a quote from perhaps one of my, I'm not going to say role models, but somebody that I look to for wisdom. And he is a historical figure. His name is Winston Churchill. And Winston Churchill once said that success is not final, failure is not fatal. It is the ability to continue that counts. And with this group, that quote to me, without a doubt, spoke to this group's perseverance and this group's willingness to continue to learn through hardship and through difficulty. Very proud of you, class of 2020. Go out and do something great. Make us all proud. All the best, Mr. Seitman.
Hi, graduates!
You all look so amazing. I know I can't see you personally in your homes, but I can feel how amazing you look. I hope you feel as good as you look. So this is your graduation day. I know it may not feel like it, but you are graduates. It's not the size or roar of the audience or even the stage you walk across that measures your accomplishments. It's you. It's all about you. Your sacrifices, your sweat and tears that brought you to this point in your life. There will be other opportunities for you to hear the crowd's roar or to have the spotlight shine upon you on someone's stage for all to see. But as long as you stay on this righteous journey set forth by you and your families, another opportunity will come. Congratulations to you all. Prieto Class of 2020. Yay! So proud of you guys.
Hey, 8th graders. I am so glad that I have the opportunity to talk to you today, even though I wish that I could be doing it in an auditorium and not over video chat, but here goes. In the first week of school, we had a class discussion about why come to math class. And I hope that by now you've come away with at least one answer to that question that doesn't involve because my parents make me, or to get good grades, or because I have to. And that we realize that there's different answers, right? It's not the same for everybody. Some people come to math class because they see it as making arguments and justifying claims and advocating for themselves. Some learn applications to the real world that they might actually use one day in their own jobs or see in their work. For some, it's just fun games and puzzles that you feel really proud of yourself when you solve. And all of those are great reasons, and there are many others. But even if you don't honestly feel that yet, even if you feel like it just kind of still feels like I do it because I have to, or, you know, I don't feel good at it yet, or, you know, it's boring or whatever, even if you, that's how you're leaving this year, I want you to know that I love you and I admire you exactly as much as that person who says that math is their favorite class, because you're more than just your opinion about math class. This year has been crazy. It's been the weirdest year of my teaching so far. And we have had our share of petty disagreements and misunderstandings and all of the rest. But what I'm going to remember most is being witness to a lot of acts of kindness and of advocacy, of creativity, of humor. I saw scholars make newcomers to the classroom feel welcome. I saw scholars defend each other when they thought someone was being treated unfairly, whether it was by another peer or by a teacher. I heard scholars direct such well-crafted jokes at me that I could not even be mad about them because they were hilarious. And as you guys transition to high school, I know that you're going to bring all of those wonderful values with you. And remember that building the kind of world we want to live in is a huge, huge task, right? But it starts small. It starts by speaking up when someone's words or actions do not sit well with you, even if there's someone in a position of authority. It starts by making that classmate that you see doesn't have friends yet feel welcome and feel comfortable, right, and how you treat them. It starts with a perfectly timed joke that brings us together instead of pushing somebody away. And if you create that kind of community in even just your table group in math class, then create it in your whole classroom, and then create it in your whole school, and then go take on the world. Congratulations, class of 2020.